Yeah, let's serve up some tennis on the SportsMax Zone. Barbados completed a successful trip to Jamaica, winning their Davis Cup World Group 2 playoff tie, which ended in Kingston on Sunday night. Here's Gerard Mariscilli, who had a close-up view of Sunday's final day. All right, so it seems as if we have some issues with that wrap. Barbados winning the tie by 3-2. It was 1-1 at the end of the opening day, which was Saturday. It started with Blaise Bicknell getting the better of Kuiper Marshall in three sets. Darian King, as he usually does, responded in the second singles rubber to defeat Roland Phillips in a three-set thriller. 7-5 in the third for Darian King, and then King returned with Haydn Lewis on Sunday to win the doubles encounter. He was thrashed by Blaise Bicknell in the third singles, the first reverse singles. It was 2-2, and it came down to Kuiper Marshall and Roland Phillips, and it was Marshall, the Barbadian, who got the job done, 6-2 in the third. Joining us on Zoom, two members of the winning Barbados team. We're going to have, first of all, a chat with Darian King, an outstanding servant of Barbados tennis. Darian, first of all, it's a pleasure to have you on the SportsMax Zone. Congratulations on a marvelous victory on Sunday night. 2 days of real exciting tennis, and you must still be over the moon after the performance of your entire team.
Yes, definitely. I'm really thrilled with the effort from the team. I'm very proud of each and everyone, even being on the team. Everyone contributed very, very well. It's a huge tie. And for us to pull that victory out, to stay in group two, is obviously the goal. And I really commend everyone on the team.
Well, first of all, let's talk about you, Darian, because your left knee was heavily strapped for the duration of the tie. There were many who felt, including myself, that probably you wouldn't have lasted the 2 days. Somehow you did, and you got two victories, one in doubles and one in singles. How are you feeling now? How is the knee?
Yes, as you say, it was a minor setback. Was preparing for the Davis Cup through some tournaments in California. Unfortunately, I had a terrible fall that resulted in a tear in my right knee, MCL, and a strain in the PCL. But gladly for the tennis, Barbados Tennis Association, all the credit goes to them by getting me here early, to seeing the best doctor, the best medical services, and for me to prepare for this tie. So I think all of this really, I owe it up to them, and I'm very happy that I could have partake to represent my country.
And how are you feeling now, a day after 2 days of rigorous action?
Beaten up. But it's all for a good cause. We end up coming out with a victory, which is what we came here for, to get the job done. And yeah, right now just trying to relax and stay positive, because this is the second time now going through a crazy injury like this. So obviously mentally it's very hard, but now it's a little off plan to try to recuperate. And as I say, thanks to the association, they're going to keep try to, in medical services and stuff, try to get me back to my high level again.
Yeah, what's the prognosis in terms of how long this entire recovery is going to take? Of course, as far as Davis Cup specifically is concerned, I think you won't be back in action until about September, being back in Group 2. But what's the prognosis on the injury and how long it will take?
Right now, they're saying I'm out for a couple months, 3 months or something like that. But yeah, I had to withdraw from the tournament, the coming tournament coming up Wednesday. I was supposed to actually play, but I think for my mind, I'm just going to take the rest and try to get back to the best of my ability. And as I say, with the help of the team that supports me, to get back out there as early as possible to represent again in September against whoever we draw.
Yeah, all right, Darian, let's relive how you guys delivered on Sunday by beating Jamaica in your Group 2 playoff World Davis Cup tie.
1-1 after day one in the Davis Cup World Group 2 playoff tie between Jamaica and Barbados at the Eric Bell National Tennis Center in Kingston, leaving all to play for on day two. It started with match three, the doubles encounter which favored Barbadian pair Haydn Lewis and Darian King, but the home pair of Blaise Bicknell and Roland Phillips got the upper hand, winning the first set 6-3. However, the Bajans rallied to win the next two sets 6-4, 6-4, taking the match 2-1 and a 2-1 advantage in the tie. But Blaise Bicknell evened things again with a win over an injured Darian King, comfortably brushing aside the former world 106, 6-1, 6-0 in match 4, giving him a perfect singles record for the weekend. With the tie locked at 2 apiece, Roland Phillips returned to the court to try and secure a win for his country against Kaipo Marsha, who had not competed since losing to Bicknell a day earlier. Despite racking up 8 double faults, Marshall held on for a 6-4 first set win. The 21-year-old Bajan improved his service, but Phillips hit back to level the contest after running away with a second 6-1. Unfortunately, Mr. Davis Cup could not build on that momentum and found himself 4-0 down in the third when the rain caused a lengthy delay. On the resumption, Marshall won the first point to secure a 5-love lead and inch closer to the promised land in front of what was now a significantly reduced crowd. Phillips did manage to snatch two games but could not stop the inevitable. Kaipo Marshall again coming up big to secure the 2-1 victory and a 3-2 win for Barbados.
You have to give credit to the Bajan team. Yeah, they came out. I thought we had it when we leveled it all. After Blaise came out firing, yeah, it was spectacular how we played and we leveled it. I thought we would have closed it off with the final singles, but that wasn't to be. This kid came out fighting and you have to give him credit.
It's unbelievable. I knew from the beginning it was going to be a hard-fought tie. Because Jamaica was a young team on the up and up. We were a more experienced team leveling off. And all respect to Jamaica, they put up a very hard fight, made it very difficult for us, and that made the victory even sweeter.
Yeah, there you have it. Barbados defeating Jamaica by 3-2 in their World Group 2 Davis Cup playoff tie at the National Tennis Center, Airbell Tennis Center in Kingston. Darian King is still with us. Darian, quickly, when you look back at the weekend, there were so many matches that could have gone differently. When you think about your own match with Roland Phillips on Saturday, you were up 5-love in the third set and Phillips came back to 5-all. When you think about the doubles match to start Sunday, where you saved a number of break points, particularly in that third set, you were down love 40 at one stage and somehow you pulled out that game. I think you were behind 2-1 at that stage. When you think back at it all, the type of grit and determination that your team showed at the weekend, you must be extremely pleased.
Oh, crazy. As I said, the effort that the guys put out there was crazy. Even myself with the torn knee and stuff, to go out there just to represent my country, to give it my all. I'm really proud of myself because I think I was really down and out telling my captain and stuff before even the tie was commencing. I was like, I don't think I'll be able to play and stuff. But surrounded by these guys kept me positive and stuff. And for me to go out there and play that first singles obviously was tough. But as I said, I'm a really different player and I'm playing for my country and I'm playing for pride. So for me, I just knew to go out there, give 100%. And I was happy to get out there to tie it in the first on the first day. Doubles, we weren't expecting it to be so tough because me and Haydn obviously have great history winning a lot of big matches against a lot of tough opponents. But Blaise and Randy, all the credit to them, as the captain said in the interview before, they put up a great fight. To me, it was a great tie overall. And I'm just happy that Barbados came up with the win. I think it could have gone either way, but I'm glad it fell in our favor. So, I mean, overall, it was a great tie, great experience for us, and unlucky to the Jamaicans. But I mean, that's how the sport is. It's only one winner, but you just have to keep on the positive path that you're playing good tennis and just try to improve each and every match.
Yeah, and quickly, because a number of the local fans, the Jamaican fans, expressing surprise and in some cases even disappointment that it was Roland Phillips and Blaise Bicknell who came up for the doubles, given that they would both have to play in the reverse singles. Were you surprised as a Barbadian team that that was the unit the Jamaicans sent out, or is that something you fully expected at 1-1?
No, I think with this format, obviously, it's very tough. You try to play your strongest players because you don't want to give an inch to either opponent or anything. So I think that all of us were obviously going out there with our biggest guns, and I was not surprised at all. You have to leave it all out there, even if you play for 5 hours and you have to go back out there and play again for 5 hours. As they say, it's Davis Cup. You're playing for your country, so I don't think that that's an excuse. Or, as you say, strategic-wise or whatever. But, I mean, I was expecting to play your biggest guns out there. It's, as I said, my foot is torn and stuff, but I have to go out there and play and represent our country. So that's a bittersweet of the game. I really enjoy the moment. You have to enjoy each and every moment of the game. It's tough sometimes, but sometimes it's buried at some point. So, for me, it's up and down, but I mean, as they say, that's how the sport is.
Yeah, Darian, I must admit that when I heard that you had a knee injury, I wondered if you got it from playing football for Watton in the Barbados Premier League, because from time to time you do represent them in the Barbados Premier League, don't you?
Yes. I try to go back and give back to my community. Obviously, I was raised in the football area, in the football community, and for me, every time I get a chance to settle down, I'll keep my mind off of tennis, I go back. That's my second sport that I go back to try to release some, you know what I mean, some stress. So yes. Football, you know, definitely is one of my sports. So I don't want to let it go. Even if I'm finished with tennis, I think I'll still be continuing playing football. But as I say, I just try to give back to the community because I think that's where how I was born and raised, and that's how it was taught with my parents and stuff. And I mean, yeah, I enjoy the sport, and I don't think that nothing can change. I don't think tennis, any other sport can change my love for football.
Yeah, and your love, of course, for your wife, because you got married just over a month ago, didn't you?
Yes. Thank you. Big moves, huh?
I know.
Love it. I'm enjoying every moment. So, yeah. As I say, a lot of new things are coming in, and non-new experiences and stuff, but I'm enjoying it, taking life moment by moment, and I'm enjoying it. As you say, I'm getting older, so the best thing for me to do is to try to enjoy each and every moment.
Yeah, and I saw some PDA after your final match yesterday, but we won't talk about that today, Darian. By the way, I understand that you're a very good cricketer as well, and that there was an Everton Weeks record that you should have broken in high school cricket, but you didn't. And someone suggested to me that maybe it is because you didn't know.
Maybe I didn't know. I didn't say I'm very thankful to God that I was multi-talented. But I don't think my heart was really leaning on the cricket. I think I would have rather football before the cricket. But
how much did you score?
Definitely was my first choice. But tennis, I think with my results and stuff coming so quickly, I think that's what pushed me there so quickly to choose tennis over football. But if it was all the sports, I think football would have been the chosen one.
How much did you score in that match, Darian?
I can't recall, but you have to tell me those statistics.
I heard it was a big hundred.
I'm not a statistician. So.
I heard it was a big hundred.
I wouldn't doubt it. I think I've achieved so much in life I'm very thankful for, but I'm not a man to keep the stats. I think that's you guys' job. I just like to go out there and do my talent.
All right, Darian, I tell you what, I probably could not win a game off you in tennis, even with your injured knee, but I bet I could get you out in cricket. Let's leave it at that. Congrats.
Thank you.
Very well done at the weekend, Darian, and we'll catch up again. All the best going forward.
Thank you very much. Appreciate you guys.
All right, let's take a quick break here on the SportsMax Zone, but when we return, we'll be speaking with the young man who finished the business for Barbados, 21-year-old Kuiper Marshall. He'll be joining us live after this. Yeah, back on the SportsMax Zone, we're talking Davis Cup tennis. Barbados defeating Jamaica at the Eric Bell Center in Kingston on Sunday night to take their World Group 2 playoff tie by 3-2. Kuiper Marshall landing the final blow, defeating Roland Phillips in 3 sets to take the tie for the Barbadians. Kuiper Marshall joins us live now on the SportsMax Zone. Kuiper, a year ago, it was Clement Mainguy in Bridgetown, Barbados, against Pacific Oceania. That time you were down 4-5 and a set, and it seemed as if you were done and dusted. This time around, with all that experience behind you, but also a Jamaican crowd against you, and still somehow in another bigger moment, you find a way to get it done. Almost 24 hours later, what's the feeling? Last year they called you a hero, the new hero of Barbados tennis. What are they calling you now?
That's a great question. I'll have to wait and see what they come up with. But yeah, as you say, I'm super excited with the victory. Definitely last year, being in the same position against Pacific Oceania, in that match, it seemed like a huge hurdle because at that point, I had not won the Davis Cup matches yet. And getting over that hurdle back then really helped me this time here in Jamaica. There's a little bit different circumstances, as you said. It was an overseas match, and I actually won the first set this time. I was up, so it was a little bit different feeling. I had to kind of learn how to close out the match. And then, I started off really well. And then in the second set, had a little bit of a dip, and then it got a little complicated. I took a bathroom break and told myself I was going to give it my all. And that's exactly what I did. I got a good start to the third set, and I was playing really well. I was really happy with my level. And I'm just super happy with the win, and I'm super grateful for the team behind me and all my supporters and everyone that's helped me get to this point.
Yeah, quick question. I noticed that you took a bathroom break at almost the end of every set. Is that something that's normal for Mr. Marshall?
I like to do that. I like to do that, especially if I lose the set. Definitely it's good for me to go in the bathroom and kind of splash some water in my face and kind of reset. Normally I don't like to do it after I win the set, but here in Jamaica, I was sweating through my clothes pretty quickly. So that was definitely a factor. I like to change my clothes and put on a new fresh set of clothes and feel nice and dry and fresh and ready to compete in the next set. So I think it was a good call on my part for sure. I did ask Darian after the first set if I should go to the bathroom and change or not, because normally you don't really want to give up that momentum, but I'm happy I did that. I think both times it kind of helped me kind of reset and refocus and go from there.
Yeah, I did an interview with you after your match against Blaise Bicknell on Saturday, and you pointed out at that time that you felt you beat yourself. You made a lot of errors. You had a lot of double faults. One thing you said to me is that you started counting the double faults. So what I did for you yesterday, I probably should have told you before, is that I counted them for you. You had 12 of them in the match, 8 in the first set, 4 in the second, none in the third. And when you were not double faulting, I would like to say for the most part, you were cruising. But what was happening on your serve all weekend?
That's a great question. I changed my rackets recently. I don't know if that has a factor to do with it or not. I'm kind of testing it out with different weights and different spots of the racket. And it's the first time that I've done this before. Normally I just buy a heavier racket, but this time I bought a little bit of a lighter racket. And I decided to kind of experiment a little bit with the weight. I don't know if this is the reason, but I mean, I always felt good on my serve this week. I think that on Saturday, I kind of just had a bad serving day. I definitely think it can happen. And I'm super happy with the way I was able to turn it around the next day. And you know, I really got some good advice from Coach Damian Applewhite and from the entire team on how to kind of go about it. And I kind of just dealt with the situation at hand. And as you said, I started the match with 8 in the first set, and that number kept dropping and dropping, and I kept building my confidence and And at the end of the match, it definitely wasn't even a factor in the match anymore. I was really confident, really comfortable. And it was just something that I kind of had to get over, and I'm happy that I was able to do that.
Yeah, I have a theory, and I want you to tell me how close I am, because when I looked at the match with Blaise Bicknell and the fact that you continued to make a lot of errors and the service mistakes as well with the double faults, I felt that maybe you were pressing too much in that match. But then against Roland Phillips, I felt that at a point, you realized that you didn't have to press as much to win the match. And so you became a lot more willing to keep the rallies going for a lot longer and just wait on those moments to pull that forehand or the backhand, which is a beautiful backhand you have, by the way. You should lend me it before you leave. And I thought it was such an important adjustment. And also, even off the serve, where you took a lot of pace off the first serve and went for the kicker, and it seemed to really work.
Yeah. I'm someone, I normally like to go for my first serve. I like to hit my first serve flat and kind of get a lot of free points off of my first serve. And that's what I expected to do coming out on Saturday against Blaise. I knew that he was also gonna come out with his big serves. I know he has a very big game as well. So it was a little bit of a different match Saturday and Sunday, because obviously Blaise plays a little bit more aggressive. He likes to use his serve and hit his big forehand and what's not. So my thinking behind it was to kind of try to dominate my service games. And I think that definitely made me go a little bit too overdriven in my service games. And that's when the errors started to come in. And going up against Randy, he's more of a kind of, he likes the longer rallies and he plays a little bit longer points. And I kind of changed the strategy in that match. I told myself, because I had played Randy before actually, and it didn't go my way that time. And I had to learn from that and kind of be a little bit more willing to extend the rallies and look for the right time to pull the trigger. And I think that's what I did really well yesterday. And I'm really happy with my patience and composure on the court.
Yeah, one final one. I mean, what do you feel that this will do for your young career? I mean, two massive victories like this in the space of 12 months is just amazing.
Yeah, for sure. This victory is one that I'm going to remember for the rest of my tennis career. I'm definitely going to build off of it, just as I did on the one against Pacific Oceania. That match helped me so much. In this past year, and I feel if I continue to build on these kind of matches, and it also builds my hunger to keep winning these big matches for Team Barbados. So I definitely plan to use this match as a stepping stone in my professional career, hopefully. This is my last semester at school and college, and I'll definitely be looking to play some professional tournaments and really give myself a chance to really reach my potential in this sport. It's a sport that I have a lot of love for, and I don't plan on stopping anytime soon. And I'm super driven and super excited for what is to come.
All right, congratulations, Kai, for a brilliant job at the weekend and definitely a fantastic job yesterday. You were definitely brilliant in that fifth rubber. You never know. Barbados still in Group 2. Well, maybe next year we could have another Caribbean clash like this, although you're hoping, I'm sure, that you'll be in Group 1 this time next year. Kai, for all the very best going forward.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
All right, Kiefer Marshall, what a performance yesterday to beat Jamaica's winningest Davis Cup player, Roland Phillips, and bring Barbados sweet, sweet victory. Let's take a break on the SportsMax Zone. We'll be back with more after this.